ready to show the world what it looks like to turn 50.
Oh, God.
This show is such a talker. It really, really is, and it sucks you in. Why did you guys think, all right, now's the time we're gonna bring this to life and kind of let the masses see what we're doing behind the scenes?
It took us, I mean, as you probably can imagine, it takes a while to actually even bring something to air. And then the actual making of the show, we wanted to make sure we were partnered with the right company, that we had a production company at our back that understood what we wanted it to look and feel like, and that we had assembled the right showrunner and the right crew. And that all took a lot of time.
Are you guys ready to go out in the field and make a ruckus?
Just another day at the office.
Do you just like have a sign-up sheet in the office and say, hey, do you want to do this crazy thing? Like, are you interested in this? Yeah.
Yeah, and that's the fun part of the show that's actually not that dissimilar from actually working at Goop, where people come in and teach classes or give talks all the time. Like, it doesn't matter if you're in accounting or you're a digital product person, you kind of get gooped. But yeah, for the purposes of the show, I sent out a Google Doc and a questionnaire and essentially was like, you cannot, these are the topics, except for female sexual pleasure, which inherently was only open to women. But yeah, people just signed up. And then the showrunner and the producers came in and they met with everyone and decided and winnowed it down from there.
How did you choose who went on the trip?
So the Goop staff sort of nominated themselves and raised their hands. I'd say almost everyone at Goop wanted to go to Jamaica.
Of all of the things that you did try, which one do you think you took the most away?
Certainly psychedelics.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I was going to say.
So I had been, it's one of those, it's, I'm sure you're like, this audience knows it well at this point. It's come back, this massive renaissance in psychedelic healing. It was very widely studied until things went a little awry in the 60s at Harvard with Timothy Leary. And then all of this research was shut down. But at the time, it was very promising for trauma and mental health. And so now we've seen this resurgence, and the FDA is starting to clear paths for it to be really studied, particularly around PTSD, addiction, and depression, some of the bigger issues in society. So I'd always wanted to try it. I never really did it as a party drug because I'm way too uptight. And so I jumped at the chance to do it with therapists who work in the medium. And then I've gone, since the show, I've gone deeper into it.
Really?
Yeah.
Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
What do you hope the audience takes away from this series?
I hope that people's curiosity is piqued. I'm sure for some people, they're going to watch and say, oh, I'm aware of all of this stuff. I think for others, it's just this, I think the question that we continually circle and push is, what do we know? And then more importantly, what do we not know? And how do we all come back to this place of feeling like we can be authorities over our own health and our wellness and get educated and go to our doctors with good questions and have conversations about our own health? I think that's the primary thing that we care about, is people feeling like they have access to the information, that we operate from that place of curiosity and non-judgment, and that we can all sort of see ourselves to a place of wellness.
She knew something that my husband didn't even know.
Gwyneth revealed some really interesting things about herself.
Yeah.
Did you find anything out about her that surprised you during this whole process of filming?
I wasn't surprised, only because I work so, like, we all work so closely with her, and she's very revealing of herself. And, you know, she's an example, I think, to all of us of someone who isn't advertising shortcuts, and she's not saying like, oh, like I was born this way. Like, she works so hard on herself.
Yeah.
And it's an inspiration to all of us, because I think she sort of epitomizes what's possible. But so for her to have, she loves opening the hood on herself, on like, why did I have that reaction? Or why am I having this emotional response? And so I'm just by virtue of working alongside of her, aware of that. So I think viewers will be surprised that she's so open.
What? This is not fair at all.
Goop has always been kind of like the cutting edge of whatever is next. So how do you and Gwyneth get together and figure out what is the next best thing or the next interesting thing?
Yeah. A lot of it comes within the referral network of the people who are friends of the brand, readers who write in, who tip us off to incredible healers, and then also doctors and scientists. So what we'll do is we'll go out to doctors within our network, or, you know, someone like Walter Longo at USC or David Sinclair at Harvard, and say, who's doing the most interesting work in this? Or what are you seeing? And then we sort of trace, we just like run those things down. And that's really sort of how we start in the content. We're not just looking for things that are inherently out there.
Right.
And it's interesting, a lot of the things that we cover are things that have been part of healing traditions for many, mm-hmm. you know, millennia. Mm-hmm. And we're just helping to push them into the mainstream.
Naked in a room with a bunch of women? I don't know if I have the guts.
You know, there is a segment of the population out there that does have criticism of what you're doing at Goop. When you hear that, how do you all handle like people saying, you know what, I think it's elitist, or they're just out there doing whatever and I don't buy it?
Yeah, I mean, one of the foundational beliefs of the brand is that we're probably not for everyone, but that everyone should be able to come to their own thing. And in the same way that we try to come from a place of open-mindedness and curiosity and non-judgment, where, you know, if you're like, I love the jade egg, that's great. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not gonna shame you or judge you for finding power in that practice. That's sort of one of our core beliefs. There's great wisdom in the masses. Let's explore some of these ideas. So for us to sort of shut down people's complaints about mm-hmm. us would not be in the spirit of who we are.
Good point.
Yeah.
It's a candle.
Yeah.
And so it's called This Smells Like My Vagina.
Okay, I do want to ask you about the candle.
Yeah.
What is the thought process behind the candle?
So the candle is actually, we sell it, but it's actually not. It's by this Douglas Little, who works with Gwyneth on all of our perfumes and candles, which do not have that name. And so he created it. I think in a conversation, she was like, oh, this kind of smells like this, at some point in its infancy. And then he was like, that's an amazing name for a candle. And so he named his candle
that. What has the response been?
Significant. the wait list, I mean, we blew out of them.
I mean,
and I think every retailer that had the candle, and now the wait list is like massive.
Oh my gosh.
He's very busy pouring wax candles.
It's all very busy in the Goopiverse, and we have a lot going on, and we're so happy that the brand has really caught on to the degree that it has. It's very cool.
Okay, what are some other Goop-approved trends like that would benefit folks during awards season that are, you know,
so
on the circuit?
I think any sort of exfoliant, so our dry brush and our Himalayan salt scrub shampoo, particularly if you have like a ton of residue on your scalp, it's the best. It works up to a lather. It has the most amazing consistency. It smells so good. It's totally clean of any harmful ingredients. And it like gets stuff out. And then our microderm, which is very popular, just a good physical exfoliant for your skin. And then we do really like rich, nourishing day creams.
We're here one time, one life. How can we really milk the out of this?